we can start the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. My dear learners, how are you? I hope that all of you are safe and sound at home. Welcome to our virtual class. Many months have passed since we met each other. Our today's topic is complete sentence. We know what is the complete sentence. Complete sentence is that there are a lot of sentences will be given to you to complete. That means you can see that there are 10 sentences. All the sentences are incomplete. And you have to complete all the sentences. So, what are the rules of complete sentences? There are a lot of rules to complete sentences. Today, I will discuss the rules of complete sentences and how to complete sentences. We know that here are 10 sentences. First one is, it is hyphen. So in terms of completing the sentences, we have to follow a structure. And what structure? What kind of structure? There is one structure. Subject plus verb plus object. If you want to complete the sentences, you have to follow this structure. First one is subject, and second one is object, and third one is, first one is subject, second one is verb, and third one is object. That means subject plus verb plus object. Now the question is that what is subject, what is verb, and what is object? I want to clarify to all of you what is subject. Subject means the doer of action. A person what performs the action of the verb. Subject. The doer of the action, the performer of the action, that is subject. And second one is, what is verb? Verb is a word or a group of words that describes an action or an event. And third one is object. What is object? Whatever or whoever receives the action of the verb, that is object. So subject plus verb plus object. That means whenever you write a paragraph, an application, an essay, or a composition, whatever you want to write, speak, you have to follow a structure. And there is subject plus verb plus object. You have to follow it. Because without this subject, you cannot, this structure, you cannot complete these sentences. So, you have to follow this structure if you want to complete the sentences. So, let us come to our discussion. The first one is, it is high time. That sentence is incomplete. So I have to complete it. How can I complete it? What is the rules of completing it? You have to follow this structure. Subject plus verb plus object. It is high time. That means you have to guess the meaning of the incomplete sentence. Then you can complete it. After getting idea, after getting the meaning of the incomplete sentence, then you can complete the sentence. At first, you have to follow the structure, you have to understand the meaning of the incomplete sentences, then you can complete it. First one is, it is high time. The meaning of this greatness is, it is the highest time. It is the best time. So what? I have to follow this step, sir. This high time, you study it at home. So here you can see that you subject, studied verb. So here it is high time. You studied at home. That means the best time you should study at home, because you should stay at home. If you stay at home, you will be safe. So here you can see that it is high time. Whenever you will find it is time or high time, you have to give the past form of the verb. It's a verb. If I want to discuss something, especially verb, I have discussed what is verb. And you know that there are verbs are two kinds. One is main verb or principal verb, and second one is auxiliary verb or helping verb. So our main verb is, if I discuss, for example, I have written three words. One is study, second one is work, and third one is decide. So, it is the verb has three forms. First one is present form or base form, second one is past or simple past, and third one is past present form. So, whenever we get this time or high time, we have to put past form or simple past form of the verb. That means main verb or principal verb. So it is high time you started at home. Okay. So come to our second sentence, incomplete sentence. Here we can see that would you mind? Would you mind? That means you are going to request someone very politely. That's why would you mind? Would you mind? Mind giving me a pen. So here we can see that mind is a verb. So if you find mind, then you have to give ing form of the verb. So we can see that ing is gerund form. Okay, that's why you get mind, then you have to give ing form of the verb. That means with whom will you add ing? The question is that, the meaningful question is that, with the present form or base form, past form or past, simple past form or past present form. The absolute correct answer is that you have to add ing with the base form, that means present form. And whenever you will add ing with any word, just see. Add ing with any verb, especially with base form, you have to just eradicate e. Yes, we can see that at the end of the word there is e. You have to cancel e, because when we add ing with any verb, can see that walk first, last. What is the meaning of the walk first? That means you should hurry not to miss something. Walk first means, walk first, last means you should hurry not to miss something. That's why walk first, last, you should miss the class. So whenever you will get last, you must bring should after subject. After subject, you should bring or you must bring this word should. It's a rule. So you know that should is a word. Modal auxiliary verb, and after modal auxiliary verb, you have to give present form or base form of main verb or principal verb. Walk fast, lest you should miss the class. Number 4, if you attend virtual class, so if you attend virtual class, you will learn many things. So you know that what is virtual class? It's also virtual class, you know that. Online class, virtual class. If you attend virtual class, so we can see that there is a condition in this sentence. If you attend, you will learn. If you don't attend, you will not learn. So there is a condition. That is called conditional sentence. So conditions, they are four conditionals. Zero conditionals, first conditionals, second conditionals and third conditionals. Zero condition is one kind of conditional, and second conditional is that real conditional. Third condition is that unreal present conditional. Fourth condition is that unreal past conditional. So there is, this sentence is conditional sentence, and this is real conditional sentence. So if you, there is a structure of this real conditional sentence. If you attend virtual class, so there is a structure of this real conditional. Real condition means what is real or true. Unreal condition is a sentence that is that is not true, that is untrue or unreal. So if you attend virtual class, you will learn many things. That is the complete, that is the answer of this sentence. Number 5 is Hasan studies hard subject. So Hasan studies hard. The answer is that Hasan studies hard so that he can pass in the examination. So, you know that he is subject, tennis verb, auxiliary verb, and passes base of main verb or principal verb. So, Hasan studies hard so that he can pass in examination. So, there is a rule that whenever you get so that, you have to bring can after the subject. Earlier, I have discussed that whenever you will complete any incomplete sentence, you have to follow the structure, the base structure, subject plus verb plus object. So here is subject. Sometimes object may not come. Okay, so Hasan studies hard so that he can pass an examination. So here that Hasan studies hard so that whenever he gets so that, you have to bring can. Then you can, tennis, you know that, tennis, modal auxiliary verb. After any modal auxiliary verb, you have to give present form or base form of the principal verb or main verb.
So number six,
if you work hard,
you would succeed.
If you work hard, you could succeed in life. So it's also conditional sentence. It's also conditional sentence. But it is unreal present. Whenever you get unreal present, you have to bring good or would after the subject. If you work hard, you could succeed in your life. And last one, number 7 is, Not so have we read the situation. This is also incomplete sentence. The answer will be, then the train left. Whenever you get notes on a hat, this structure, you have to bring them. And after them, you have to give past simple tense or past simple of the verb or past form verb. So notes on a hat is the situation, then the train left. And this one is, the organ is chewy, that means the organ is very tired. The organ is very tired. So, the organ is chewy to walk. That means he is chewy that he cannot walk. Very tired person. So, two here is two is infinitive. You know that after infinitive, you have to give the base form or present form of the verb. So, two is infinitive. 5 years have passed since. Since I saw you, that means 5 years have passed since I saw you. Actually, it was a long time I saw you. That was, it happened many years ago. That is why 5 years have passed since I saw you. So whenever you get this kind of sentence, 5 years have passed, 6 years have passed, 10 years have passed, have to since. Then you have to give the past form of the verb, but you have to give past simple form of the verb. That means after since you have to bring past simple tense. He speaks as if. Speaks as if you were a madman. That means, you know that whenever you get as if, then you have to give the word. You have to give word. But we know that basically after he, whenever we mean past form, past tense, after he, she, it, we have to give was. We have to bring was. But there is a rule that after as if, whenever you get as if, then you have to give word for the all the subjects, all the pronouns, subject pronoun, like I, we, you, he, she, they, it. All the pronouns, after all the pronouns, you have to give word. Whenever you get as if, this one. So, dear learners, I have tried my best to discuss how to complete sentences. I think all of you just will attend the classes, virtual class, and you will learn many things if you understand this class. So at the end of the class, I want to say something. Stay home and try to stay home. And whenever you will take something to eat. Whenever you eat something, you have to wash your hands at least 20 seconds. All the best.